With me, Mr. Hank Stewart. How are you?
Three times real fast.
Now, what have you enjoyed thus far? It's been 4 days. There's been mega things going on, from panels, movies. Have you caught any of the screening?
I love Angie Stone. Angie Stone is, and then the entree is Miss Marla Gibbs.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, she is just she's just a bomb, and you know, her spirit is just incredible. You know, and what she's done for our community, mm-hmm. you know, and our people, bringing the laughter, but bringing the quality in it as well. Mm-hmm. You can't underestimate that. And so I think that's been my highlight.
Right. Now, of course, you're well known in Atlanta. You're always doing your thing. You know, what are you going to take away from this 4 days with you in terms of what you do?
Well, you know what? What you learn when, you know, there's a quote that I absolutely love. It says, amateurs do it until they get it right. Mm-hmm. Professionals do it until they can't get it wrong. And I've been around professionals this last 4 days, and you just want to hone in on your craft a little bit more because they show you that you have to be at your top of your game. And so no matter how good you think you are, there's still a level of improvement. And so that's what I got from this 4 days. Hello, my name is Hank Stewart, Behind the Mic Live with Nikki Simone.
I think Bill Cosby said, I don't know the key to success, but I know the key to failure, and that's trying to please everybody. And I was so guilty of that. If I could have known at 20 what I finally figured out by the time I was getting close to 40, almost 80, and I could be so much further along right now.
You gotta make yourself as unique and exclusive as possible for agents and studios to want to, you know, party with you.
You have to remember that an agent works 10%. Work 90.
Exactly.
You have to market and sell yourself. An agent can only do so much. We can get you in the room. What you do in the room is what you do in the room.
I was like, oh my God, this is real. I was like, this is for real. Like, so we sit there and he go, yo, what's up, Jim? What's up, man? First thing, he ain't get a line. He says, hey, somebody get some powder over here, but like a piece of bacon. No, I looked at Warren and was like, they gave me a laugh, like, I said, okay, I'll laugh with it because I was ready to go in, but I said, you know what? I don't want to mess this movie up. I don't want to lose my job. But, you know, I ain't scared of you, dog.
Let's give it up for Lex Gibson. And his partner, Mr. J.B. Brown. With J.B. Brown. The dynamic duo. JB, and I just want you to know that both of them have something in common with myself. I come from one of the islands, St. Thomas, and JB and Len also come from one of the islands.
Which one?
Rikers. Anyway,
type it up, because it's so different from the script. I would type it up and send it to the studio. This is tomorrow, we're shooting this. This is not in the script. So the studio read, oh, no, don't do that. I said, why not? He said, it's not funny. I said, well, no, I think it is funny. Listen, if you shoot that, we will fire you. This is my first big job. So the studio said, we'll fire you. I said, okay. So I went to the building. I said, President Paramount Pictures told me that this scene is not funny, and if they shoot it, they're going to fire me. And Murphy said, you work for me, not for them. So we got to sing.
Mr. Hutman here. He is the producer of the hot movie Boomerang. How are you?
I'm well. You know, I'm very happy that 20 years has passed and people are celebrating what we did 20 years ago. I think it's something that has legs and durability.
How did you guys even come up with the concept to do a Boomerang movie?
Well, actually, it was Eddie Murphy's concept. Eddie Murphy called us up. He had seen House Party. We liked House Party. He said, listen, work with me. So it took us about, let me think about it. 2 seconds, then, yes, we'll do it. You know?
What do you remember most fondly about working with the different cast members?
Well, it was an ensemble. You got Chris Rock, Eddie Murphy, David Allen Greer, Martin Lawrence. It was almost like a jazz team. Everybody was just doing their part and mixing together. So it was really the excitement of the interaction. John Witherspoon. Coordinate! Don't forget that. Coordinate!
Now, will there be a Boomerang 2, possibly?
No, probably not, which is very disappointing to me that people really remember it. But, you know, that was that moment. I have a really important new project, but I've sworn an oath of secrecy. But the next 30 days, we should know.
How are you enjoying the PBIFF so far?
You know, this festival is really wonderful. And I know some of our festival. I produced the Acapulco Black Film Festival years ago in Mexico. So I really know how hard this is, and I know what a great success this is, because this is not easy. But it's really wonderful gathering of folks and films and exchanging of ideas.